Good morning, everyone, and welcome back after summer. We have a very special guest this morning. I'd like to welcome Harrison Elhabal. He is one of our parish seminarians, and we're going to hear from him for a few minutes before Mass starts.
All right, hello, everyone. Like Libby said, my name is Harrison Elhabal. I'm going to my second year in seminary at St. John Vianney in St. Paul, Minnesota. And yeah, very briefly, I'm going to try to share with you my story and just, hope you guys get to know me a little bit more. So I often get asked the question, what's your story? Why do you want to be a priest? And kind of just like, especially all throughout the summer doing totus tuus, I was asked that question by host families or by kids, and there's a very simple way of answering it, and there's a long way of answering it. You can answer it in so many different ways, because in a way it's God's story, and God's story is extraordinary. But ultimately, the reason why I want to be a priest is because God chose me. We never choose God. God always chooses us first. Everything we do is a response to his love for us. And so I remember the first thing I wanted to be was a priest when I was at 7 years old. I have no idea why. Shortly after, I wanted to be a cowboy and go to space and do the military and all that kind of stuff. But I just remember at a really young age, the first thing I remember I wanted to be was a priest. And God just put that desire in my heart. And it took me a long time to respond to that call. I was very afraid of it most of my life. But ultimately, God put the right people in my life, the right priests, the right fathers, the right role models, to help me see the beauty of the priesthood, to help me see that the priesthood is a beautiful life, that it's a close relationship with Jesus, and that he gives you everything you need to be truly happy, to be truly fulfilled. I can think of one specific moment. I lived in Virginia for 10 years. That's part of my story. I lived in Virginia, and then only 2 years ago, I moved to Omaha and joined St. Wenceslaus Parish. But while I was in Virginia, I knew this priest named Father Care, and Father Care, one of the last things he said to me was before I was moving, I was kind of upset because I loved Virginia, but I felt like God was calling me here. And Father Care said to me, he said, "It's good that your heart's breaking, because it shows that you gave your heart to the people around you." And then he said, "That's the heart of a priest. And Harrison, I believe you have the heart of a priest." And then he said, "God never gives you less than what you had before. So you can trust in the Lord." And that gave me the courage to move to Virginia. And he truly has given me everything I've needed and all the more. God is a great giver, and he always gives us so much. And he's loved me so much, and he's prepared my heart. And he prepared me enough to take the step to go to seminary. And yeah, since being in seminary, it's been the best time of my life. I've been able to meet great friends. I actually play rugby, which is kind of like football, but a little crazier. It's really fun, but I play that at my school. I get to study philosophy, which is interesting, but fun and crazy also. But ultimately, I just get to grow in my relationship with Jesus in seminary. And he gets to continue to build my desire for a greater relationship with him. And so that's part of my story. And ultimately, I'm here because God called me, and he also has a special call for each and every one of us here. And that's why we're here at Mass. That's why we pray. That's why we go to confession, do everything in the church, because God has a plan for our life. He chose each and every one of us, and he knows us. And he's called us by name, and we're his. We belong to him. We're his children, and he's our Father, and he loves us. So, thank you so much for hearing me, and I'm looking forward to seeing you at St. Wenceslaus. Thank you.
Good morning and welcome back. The administration, teachers, and staff are excited to have you back as we begin another school year. As we begin this new school year, let us ask God, through the power of the Holy Spirit, to renew Christ's light within us so that we can shine brightly as students of St. Wenceslaus and as children of God.
Our processional song can be found in the hymnals, number 836, Gather Us In, number 836. Please rise.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, as we gather this morning to celebrate the Blessed Virgin Mary and her assumption to the right hand of the Father, we recognize that where she has gone, to heaven, that is where we want to go. And the Lord helps us on that path, and especially as we fail on that path, as we sin, as we hurt one another, He offers us His forgiveness and His mercy. So as we begin, let us take a moment to call to mind our sin, but more importantly, let us call to mind God's forgiveness and mercy today. Lord Jesus, You are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul into heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attentive to the things that are above, we may merit to share in her glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was opened, and the Ark of the Covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its heads were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth to devour her child as she did give birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his anointed one." The word of the Lord.
Our response is, "The Queen stands at your right hand arrayed in gold." The Queen stands at your right hand arrayed in gold. The Queen takes her place at your right hand in gold of Ophir. The Queen stands at your right hand arrayed in gold. Hear, O daughter, and see, turn your ear, forget your people and your father's house. The Queen stands at your right hand arrayed in gold. So shall the King desire your beauty, for he is your Lord. The Queen stands at your right hand arrayed in gold. They are borne in with gladness and joy. They enter the palace of the King. The Queen stands at your right hand arrayed in gold.
A reading from the first letter to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ, the first fruits. Then, at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end. When he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for he subjected everything under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greetings, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and have lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord. Good morning, and welcome back. In the gospel today, we hear Mary proclaim her great Magnificat. She says that she rejoices. Her spirit is filled with that joy. Now, how many of you this morning, with the first day of school, your whole being proclaims the greatness of the Lord, your spirit rejoices in God your Savior? How many are excited to be here? How many wish there's 2 more weeks of summer vacation? A lot more of those. Well, we don't have that. But we are invited to be filled with that joy, and the joy that we have, and the joy especially celebrating today, One is that we're all back together for this new school year. This opportunity to grow in knowledge and love of God, to get to know Him and to draw closer to Him, and to be with one another as a community of faith, as a school community, to grow together in that knowledge and love and service to one another. You know, our theme for this year is trust in the Lord. We're invited to trust that the Lord is with us each and every step of our life. He is here with us as we're beginning this school year. He is with us every moment. And He's going to be with us in every moment, in those great moments of happiness and joy that we'll experience, and even in those difficult days, those rough days. The Lord is with us, and we're invited to trust in that. And ultimately, to trust what the Lord desires for us, what He truly wants for each and every one of us, is to be happy with Him forever in heaven. And that's the feast we celebrate today. Mary ascended, was assumed, up into heaven. At the moment of her death, assumed body and soul, because she became the first of that. In the creed that we're going to pray in just a moment, we believe in the resurrection of the dead. We believe that our bodies and souls will be with God in heaven, our bodies transformed and changed, but we'll be with Him forever. And that's what the Lord's desire, and we're to trust in that promise. Mary trusted in the Lord. She trusted in the Lord and in her mission to be the mother of Jesus. And here in the gospel today, she reaches out. She reaches out to her cousin, who she knew from Gabriel, was also with child. We are to trust, like Mary, in that hope and that promise. You know, 10 years ago was the first time that I ever got to go to the Holy Land. I've been there twice. I was there 3 years ago and the first time 10 years ago. And both times visited the Church of the Visitation. That is the story we hear, that Mary goes to visit Elizabeth today. And the church is truly in the hill country of Judea. When we got there near the site, our tour guide says, "I've got good news for you, and I've got bad news for you." He said, first, the bad news. The Church of the Visitation is way up there in that hill, and the bus can't make it up there. You got to walk up there. He said, but the good news is, when you get back down to the bottom, the best ice cream and gelato shop in Israel is at the bottom of the hill. And so we knew that by walking up that hill, going up there to the site of the Visitation, spending some time up there in prayer, that when we got down, there was going to be ice cream at the bottom of the hill. What we recognize today and what we see in faith is that our journey of life, with all the good things, and in that journey up that hill, was challenging. It was a warm, hot day. We made it up there. We got up to the top, and it was about 12:30 when we got there, and there was a sign that said closed until 1:30. So then we had to wait, and that was frustrating. But then we got the chance to go into the site, into the church, to pray, to tour, and then made our way down. When we got to the bottom, there was the best ice cream I've ever had. You know, our life's journey, we're going to have good times, right? And I'm sure this school year is going to be filled with some good times. Successes in the classroom, successes on the volleyball court, and the basketball court, and the football field, and the track, the volleyball court, the baseball field, softball field. There'll be those moments of joy and excitement. And there's also going to be those difficult days. And that's true for all of our life. But what's at the end is the joys of heaven and being with the Lord forever. Mary was the first to experience that. But all of us will follow. I don't know if you've noticed since last Sunday here in the church, more of the stained glass windows have been put in. And I was thinking, we're surrounded by men and women, saints of the church, who walked that journey through the joys and through the challenges, and now are with God in heaven. They continue to pray for us and prompt us on. May we be filled with hope and joy this day. May we be like Mary, that our spirits are filled and rejoice. Because what awaits us is such great glory, that fulfillment of the promise. And may we live the theme that we have this year, trust in the Lord. He's with us today as we gather for this first Mass of the school year, and He'll be with us to take every step through this year. We do have an incredible faith. We believe, as I said, in the resurrection of the dead and life everlasting. Let us together stand and make that full profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begot, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the Scriptures, He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. In faith and in hope and trust in our Lord, we present our prayers and needs this day.
For those who serve our church and help us grow in our faith, especially Pope Francis, Archbishop Lucas, Father Mike, Father Tim, Father Tobias, Father Andy, and all the religious and lay ministers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who serve in public office, that they may lead with wisdom and understanding, respecting the dignity of all people as children of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of Ukraine and all places in our world currently experiencing war, that they will soon know peace and freedom from fear, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the staff and students who are new to St. Wenceslas School, that they may feel welcomed and encouraged to share their gifts with us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick of our parish family and school community, for their caregivers, and for all who have requested our prayers, that Jesus will ease their burdens and give them comfort and strength. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's blessing on the coming school year, may each of us allow the light of Christ to shine brightly in our hearts so that we can be examples of God's love for all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Phil Heller, who we are remembering at this Mass, and for all the needs we hold within the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear these prayers, give answer according to your will, if we offer them through the intercession of Mary, in the name of her Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Our offertory song can be found in the hymnal number 893, Immaculate Mary, number 893.
My sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this oblation, our tribute of homage, rise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, may our hearts, aflame with the fire of love, constantly long for you. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just,
our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For today, the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your church's coming to perfection, and a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of all life. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you've created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you have willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Wenceslaus, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people your Son has gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us stand, and at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in singing our communion song, "Hail Mary, Gentle Woman."
Holy Mary, Mother of God.
Pray for us.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go forth rejoicing, trusting in the Lord.
Our recessional song can be found in the hymnals, number 883. Hail, Holy Queen, enthroned above, number 883.
I cannot think of a better way to start the school year than all of us coming together and praying at Mass. And we want to thank all the parents, grandparents, guests who came to celebrate Mass with us today. Thank you for being here. Father Mike touched on it just briefly in his homily, but there are 18 new stained glass that were put in here over the last couple of weeks, from the Sacred Heart of Jesus to the Immaculate Conception for Mary, St. John the Baptist, Mary's parents, St. Anne and St. Joseph up here, the three archangels, Gabriel, St. Michael, and St. Raphael. There is so much history and tradition in these stained glass that maybe we could ask the teachers each week to come in and pick one of those stained glass and talk to the students about it, because there's 18 of them that are in. And that's basically a whole first semester, one a week. So it's a perfect opportunity to come in and share some more. But again, I just want to thank the parents, grandparents, guests. You are welcome to come to every Mass that we have throughout the year, any of the sacraments we have, anything that you can share your faith and religion with us. We want you to join us and be part of that. For the students, okay, it's the first time we're dismissing. And so it's a whole other concept. So we'd like the kindergarten to go ahead and leave with the eighth grade, followed by fifth grade, following them out through the Cane Hall foyer. We'd like 6th, 7th, and 8th grade to go ahead and enter out through the main doors to head back to class, and then the other grades will follow them and all. So welcome back, everyone. It's great to see all your shiny faces. It's going to be a great school year. God bless you all.